All right, guys, in this video, I'm going to talk about main bearing clearances, well, bearing clearances in general. I'm going to run through the main bearing side of it. I might do the connecting rod side of it too. I've got everything set up here, crankshaft on these V-blocks I printed, rods and pistons all hung, the block. So check the video out, subscribe to see our other videos, and yeah, check this thing out, and I'll show you how we do main bearing clearance. Okay, some people would use plastic gauge or some other way to measure main bearing clearance. What I prefer to do is I have this in here, right next to the block, you can see. I will mic the crankshaft. In this case, we're doing the back journal first. I'll mic the crankshaft, I'll put the mic in a vise, and then I'll set my dial bore gauge to that mic reading. That'll give me a true, zero from there. I'll put the bearing in the block, main cap in the block, torque stuff as per, this is an ARP, so these are 80 in the center, 245 on the outside in three steps. So we'll get that torqued, and then I will measure it. I can tell you currently that this is tight. This thing is 1.5 thou in the back. Everybody's gonna have their own spec for what they wanna see here. Best advice I can give you is talk to someone who builds a lot of that specific engine. Keep in mind, material does make a difference. Aluminum or iron block. This is an aluminum block with an iron cap. Some of the import stuff has, an aluminum main girdle more than just a main cap, and an aluminum block. So keep that in mind too when you're setting this stuff, because it does expand differently, obviously. So I'm going to check this again just to confirm, really this is 1.5 thou, and then I'm going to pull this cap. This is a set of Michigan 77 bearings. I've got a set of King bearings here that are 1 thou extra clearance for the Coyote, and then I have a standard set of Kings here as well. The clearances do change from manufacturer to manufacturer. I've seen a couple tenths. M77 or Clevite, which is what's in this, are generally the tightest in my experience. So I'm probably going to put a standard set of Kings in there just to see. What you also can do, and not many people know this, is you can swap halves. So we can do the bottom half as a standard size King and the top half as a 1 thou extra clearance King bearing. I try to stick within manufacturers, but you can mix those as well. I don't suggest it because the coatings are different and I don't know how they act with each other, but yeah, so that'll give you, if you do that, if you mix the standard and 1 thou extra, that'll give you a 1/2 thou rather than the 1 thou. So you can get pretty picky on your bearing clearance targets. So I'm going to confirm this main bearing clearance a second, and then I'm going to swap a set of bearings in it and go right down the line. I start the back first just because the engine stand is obviously in the way. I'll lay the dial bore gauge in here. It'll sit in there. I'll move it, move it up and down to find the tight spot to where it's straight in there, square in there. And once we get that cap set, I'll move the next one all the way down the line until we're done. The rod bearing side, I do the same thing with. I'll set the micrometer to the crankshaft journal, and then I'll put a rod bearing set in the connecting rod. I'll torque the connecting rod in a soft jawed mic, and I'll use the dial bore gauge to mic the clearance. Obviously it's a pretty time consuming process, but it's the only way to ensure all of these things are set correctly. So I'm gonna get moving on this stuff. Okay, I got all the main caps in there, measured, checked the size. You saw me bouncing back and forth between the crankshaft and the block. My micrometer and my vise, or well, specifically my vise, are in the other room there. So that's what I was doing. I was running back over there, set the mic in the holder, and check the dial bore gauge against it before I come back here and check the bearings. But these are all good. Interesting point. The standard king bearing got me to the clearance I was looking for, and the standard cleavite bearing was too small. So again, moving between manufacturers can have that benefit. That's what I often see, is that cleavite is the tighter of the three I normally use, the three being cleavite, M77, King, and ACL. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the caps back off, and we'll get the crankshaft in it and torqued. And then we'll check rod clearance at that point. So I'm not going to make a video of that, just because it's pretty much the same process you just watched, only with the connecting rod. And I so, but yeah, that's how we check bearing clearance here. If, you know, again, some people use plastic gauge. I found that to be very inconsistent. I much prefer the dial bore gauge method, as we just did. So. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to watch future videos like this. Engine assembly, dyno videos, all kinds of stuff we've got coming down the line. So, and comment if there's anything else you want to see, want us to talk about. Love to hear your feedback.